Please subscribe to our channel by pressing the subscribe button and the bell icon to receive updates on new videos.
Ramakrishna Matam Hyderabad Vari Saujanyanto, ee karyakramalni nirvahistunnaru. ఇక ప్రతి ఎపిసోడ్లోని మీకు ఏ విషయాలు ఉంటాయి, ఏం అంశాలు ఉంటాయన్న విషయం గురించి చెప్పడానికి నేను ఈరోజు మీ దగ్గరకు వచ్చాను. ప్రతి ఎపిసోడ్ని కూడాను మేము కొన్ని సెగ్మెంట్స్గా డివైడ్ చేసుకున్నాం. ఆ సెగ్మెంట్స్ గురించి మీకు చెప్పబోతున్నాను. ఇప్పుడు నేను చెప్పబోయేటువంటి సెగ్మెంట్స్ ఇదే ఆర్డర్లో వస్తాయని రూల్ లేదు, కానీ ఈ సెగ్మెంట్స్ మాత్రం మీకు ఉంటాయి. ఏమేమి ఉంటాయి? కాన్వర్జేషన్స్, స్టోరీ నరేషన్, నెక్స్ట్ సెగ్మెంట్లో వచ్చేసరికి థర్డ్ సెగ్మెంట్లో ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ అండ్ ఇన్స్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ గ్రేట్ పర్సనాలిటీస్, ఒక పారబెల్ ఆర్ అన్ ఎనెక్డోట్, గ్రామర్ అండ్ ఒక కోట్. సో ఇలాగ ఒక 5 సెగ్మెంట్లు అనుకోండి సుమారుగా. ఈ సెగ్మెంట్ల గురించి కొంచెం వివరాలు ఇస్తాను మీకు. ఇప్పుడు ఉదాహరణకి నేను చెప్పిన ఆర్డర్లోనే వెళ్తాను. కాన్వర్జేషన్స్, కాన్వర్జేషన్ అంటే ఏంటి? ఓ ఇద్దరు వ్యక్తులు సంభాషిస్తూ ఉంటారు, మాట్లాడుకుంటూ ఉంటారు. వాళ్ళు మాట్లాడుతున్నప్పుడు అందులో ఉన్నటువంటి ఇంగ్లీష్ లాంగ్వేజ్ని, వారు యూజ్ చేస్తున్న ఫ్రేజెస్ ఆర్ వర్డ్స్, ఆ పదాలు, వాటి యొక్క స్ట్రక్చర్స్, వాటన్నిటిని కూడా అబ్జర్వ్ చేయండి. స్టోరీ నరేషన్, ఒక కథని మీకు చెప్తాం. చెప్తున్నప్పుడు కథ మీకు స్క్రీన్ మీద కనిపిస్తుంది. అది చూస్తూ ఆ స్పెల్లింగ్ని, ఆ ప్రొనౌన్సియేషన్స్ని, మళ్ళీ వన్స్ అగైన్ ఆ గ్రామర్ని అవి అబ్జర్వ్ చేయండి. ఇదే కాకుండా మీకు ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ కానీ, అంటే ఈ గొప్ప వ్యక్తుల యొక్క జీవితంలో జరిగినటువంటి స్ఫూర్తిదాయకమైనటువంటి విషయాల్ని కానీ, లేకపోతే ఒక పారబల్, ఒక ఎనెక్డోట్ అంటే చిన్న చిన్న కథల్ని కానీ చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. ఇక్కడ కూడా మీరు చేయవలసింది ఏంటి, ఆ చెప్తున్నటువంటి విషయాల్లో భాషని మీరు అబ్జర్వ్ చేయడమే, ఇంగ్లీష్ని అబ్జర్వ్ చేయడం, ఆ యొక్క పదాలు, వాటి యొక్క గ్రామర్ అదంతా కూడా అబ్జర్వ్ చేయడం. ఇదే కాకుండా గ్రామర్ సెగ్మెంట్ వచ్చేసరికి మీకు ఇంగ్లీష్ గ్రామర్ని నేర్పడం జరుగుతుంది. ఈ ఇంగ్లీష్ గ్రామర్లో కూడాను ప్రతి ఎపిసోడ్లోని ఒకటే పాయింట్ చెప్పేయడం అని కాకుండా, అది బహుశా 2-3 ఎపిసోడ్లో కూడా వెళ్ళొచ్చు. ఆ గ్రామర్ పాయింట్ యొక్క పూర్తి ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్, కొన్ని ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్, దాని యూసేజ్ అండ్ ఈవెన్ ఎక్సర్సైజెస్ ఉంటాయి. ఎక్సర్సైజెస్ ఒక్కొక్కప్పుడు అదే ఎపిసోడ్లో ఉండొచ్చు, లేకపోతే కొన్ని హోంవర్క్గా ఇచ్చి నెక్స్ట్ ఎపిసోడ్లో కూడా డిస్కస్ చేస్తూ ఉండొచ్చు. ఇక ఇంకొక సెగ్మెంట్ వచ్చేసి ఒక కోట్ చూపిస్తాం మీకు స్క్రీన్ మీద. సో ఆ కోట్ని మీరు ఏమిటి, అందులో చెప్పిన విషయం ఏమిటి అనేది ఆలోచించండి. ఆ విషయాలన్నింటినీ కూడాను మీ జీవితంలో ఏ విధంగా వాటిని అక్కడింపు చేసుకోవచ్చు, ఏ విధంగా వాటిని తీసుకోవచ్చు అనే విషయాన్ని తీసుకుని మీరు భాష నేర్చుకుంటూ ఉండాలి. సో ఈ ఇంగ్లీష్ భాష నేర్చుకోవడం, భాష అనేసరికి అది అన్ని రకాల సమ్మేళనంగా ఉంటుంది. అందుకోసం చెప్పేసి మీకు మేము ప్రతి ఎపిసోడ్ని కూడా ఈ విధంగా మేము డిజైన్ చేయడం జరిగింది. అంటే కేవలం ఒక క్లాస్లో ఏదో జరుగుతున్నటువంటి ఒక గ్రామర్ పాఠంగా కాకుండా, మీకు ఈ 4-5 రకాలుగా దీన్ని మీకు నేర్పడానికి మేము ప్రయత్నం చేస్తున్నాం. ఈ విధంగా మీరు ఇంగ్లీష్ని సులభంగా చక్కగా నేర్చుకోగలరని చెప్పి ఆశిస్తున్నాం. మరి ఇవాళ ఎపిసోడ్లోకి వెళ్ళిపోదామా.
హలో ఎవ్రీవన్, గుడ్ డే టు యు ఆల్. నౌ లెట్ us లెర్న్ సమ్ గ్రామర్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ అండ్ లెర్న్ హౌ టు బిల్డ్ English sentences through it.
So we have discussed how to make use of positives and negatives. So today we are going to discuss about how to frame questions in making use of simple present tense. So whatever the auxiliary, whatever the helping verb which we use in the negatives, the same helping verb is used in the question forms also. So making use of do and does. Okay, so do is used with the any idea?
Madam. I, we, you, they.
Okay, exactly. With I, we, you and they, we make use of do. Then V1 form. Does is used with he, she and it. Plus V1. Making use of the same structure with do and does, we can also add some WH words before. Whenever we use these WH questions or SRNO questions, then we have to ask questions about our regular activities. So talking about our regular activities and all, at what time do we wake up? So roju ennintiki lestaru lekapothe office ki ela eltaru? So per month meer entha kharchu pedtaru, then entha save chestaru? So ivanni questions adagalante meek simple present tense lone use chese adagali. So daniki do form and does form use chestamu. Ade kaakunda wh words kuda meer upayoginchochu. So what do you mean by wh words? Wh words ante getting information. Okay, direct questions. We can also call these as direct questions. Okay, so wh word use chesi adige questions, wh questions. So leave about the structure and all, can you give me some examples for wh questions?
When do you wake up?
Okay, when do you wake up?
When do they release
leave about the structure. Okay, so give some examples for wh questions.
What is the time?
What's the time now? Okay.
Where are you going?
What do you like?
What do you like? Right.
How do you?
Are you from?
Where are you from? Good.
What do you do?
What do you do? What
how do much you money do you earn per month?
How much money do you earn per month?
What do you eat?
What do you eat? Okay. So whatever the questions, we're starting with WH word, and whatever it may be, with all the tenses also, we get WH questions. So now we are making questions, the combination is WH word, and first we'll discuss WH questions, and after that we'll move to SRNO. First give the combination WH word and also do or does, okay, according to your choice. Then make a question, and in this context usually students get a doubt, because in positives we add S or ES form to the V1, but whereas in negatives we don't add S or ES form. Okay, so if you say that one, he wakes up, he doesn't wake up, he doesn't wake up. And even in the question form also, we don't add S or ES form, we make use of only V1 here. No, please don't add S or ES form. If you add S or ES form, your structure is wrong. So making use of this structure, can you come up with some examples?
What do you do in free time?
That's good. Okay, so what do you do in free time? అంటే మీరు ఫ్రీగా ఉన్నప్పుడు, అంటే మీకు ఓకే, సో లీజర్ టైంలో మీరు జనరల్గా ఏం చేస్తారు? దానికి హౌ టు ఆన్సర్ దట్ క్వశ్చన్?
హౌ రీడ్ బుక్స్.
దట్స్ గుడ్. ఓకే, సో ఐ రీడ్ బుక్స్. ఓకే, హరిప్రసాద్ వాట్ యూ డూ?
ఐ
లిసన్ టు మ్యూజిక్. ఓకే, రాము వాట్ యూ డూ ఇన్ ఫ్రీ టైమ్?
ఐ లిసన్ టు న్యూస్.
ఐ లిసన్ టు న్యూస్. ఓకే, సో వాట్ డూ యూ డూ ఇన్ ఫ్రీ టైమ్? వాట్ డూ యూ డూ in free time? Okay, so next,
at what time do you go to your office?
Okay, that's good. At what time do you go to office? At what time do you go to office? So now here you see the structure. Close the WH word and see the structure. Do you do? And if you see that one, at what time do you go? So we are making use of do, then plus subject, then after that we are making use of V1 form. Okay, so give some more examples.
When do you wake up?
Yeah. When do you wake up?
What do you eat?
What do you
eat?
What do you eat? Okay, so instead of at what time do you take breakfast is better, because what do you eat in the sense, every day do you eat the same? Do you eat idli every day?
No ma'am. No,
okay,
no.
So we eat different. So instead of that, better. Okay, or so like some elderly people and all, that one they have rotis at night. So what do you eat at night? Okay, as South Indians, most of us have rice for lunch. We don't eat rotis. Okay, so we have the habit of eating rice. Okay, so when do you take your breakfast? When do you take your breakfast? So So in asking these questions, automatically whenever we make use of you, sometimes you is used for singular and you is also used for plural. If I want to ask only one person, then I can say that one, at what time do you wake up? If I want to ask all of you also, the question is same. Because you is used for singular and plural, it depends on the context. But whenever you make use of a question, you have to consider it as a plural form, and always with do it is you only, but we don't make use of does. So okkar nadina ekku okkar kante ekku mandi nadina kuda meer do ne use chesi use cheyal gaani adi singular ga use chesi eppudu usually we ask like okay, so where are you? Okay, calling a person and asking the person and all that one, ekkadunnara ani adagadaniki where are you? Okka person adagalanna. Ledu, more than one person adagalanna kuda ade question. So always anduke plural de use chesi adagali. Okay, so can you make some questions with do and they combination?
Where do they spend their holiday?
Okay. Where do they spend their holidays? రోజు వెయిట్ చేస్తారా? ఇవాళ ఎంతసేపు వెయిట్ చేస్తారా? యు కెనాట్ ఆస్క్ అబౌట్ టుడే. వాట్ ఆర్ దే ఇన్ ఆర్కెమట్? ఇన్ ఆర్కెమట్. Okay, so then like you can say that one, what do they do on Sundays? Okay, here you can also take make use of what do they do is, what do her children do on Sundays? Okay, you can also say that one, how do her children go to school? How do her children go to school? Ante vaalla her children automatically, then we can substitute with they. How do they go to school? Can you come up with some examples with he, she and it?
Ma'am, when do they come to class?
That's good. Okay, so when do they come to class? Okay, when do they come to class? And you can also ask a question if you want to ask your friend. Okay, how do your teachers teach in your college? How do they teach? Okay, so if you want to find out. Okay, so next.
With whom do you go out?
Yeah, that's good. With whom do you go out? With whom do you go out? Okay, so next.
Where do they go in the early morning?
Where do they go early morning, right? So where do they go early morning? They go for a walk in the morning. They go to Indira Park for morning walk. Okay, so next. Make use of does.
Does she do?
What does she do? Other than what does she do? Okay, we can also use that. Like, what does your mother do? What does your mother do in the afternoon? Or what does your mother do in the evening? What does she watch on TV? What does she watch on TV? Okay, so next.
What does she like?
That's right. Okay, so what does she like? So other than what, can you make use of other WH words?
Where does he stay?
That's good. Okay, so where does he stay? Okay, so in the place of he, we can also say that one. Okay, so where does Ravi stay? Where does Ramu stay? So in this way, you can make use of. Okay, so in the place of he, you can change accordingly.
Where does it buy?
Where does it?
Buy.
Where does it buy? What is it?
Pen, for example, pen.
Ever gone taru?
So my friend, if my friend.
Okay, so for your. No, 1 second, Ramu. Can we make use of. It for your friend, can we use?
Hari Prasad, he has bought one pen madam.
Okay.
I asked him, where does it buy? Where does
so, Hari Prasad already pen konunte, then manam em adagalante ekkada konnavo ani adagali. బట్ ఇక్కడ ఏంటంటే మనము రెగ్యులర్గా మీరు పెన్స్ ఎక్కడ కొంటారు రెగ్యులర్గా లేకపోతే రెగ్యులర్గా అంటే మనము ఓకే సో ఒకటే షాప్లో లేకపోతే వీ బై క్లోత్స్ ఇన్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ షాప్ ఓకే మేబీ బిగ్ బజార్ హైదరాబాద్ సెంట్రల్ లేకపోతే చర్మాస్ కానీ ఏదన్నా సో అప్పుడు దెన్ వేర్ డూ యూ బై క్లోత్స్ ఇక్కడ ఏంటంటే ఒక పెన్ గురించి అడిగేటప్పుడు ఇది ఆల్రెడీ అయిపోయిన యాక్షన్కి యూజ్ చేయాలి ఇప్పుడు మనం డూ అండ్ డస్ ఏంటంటే మనం రెగ్యులర్ యాక్టివిటీస్కి యూజ్ చేస్తాము అయిపోయిన దానికి యూజ్ చేయం కాబట్టి సో అది యూజ్ చేయలేము Okay, so like you can say that one, which newspaper does your father read? We have the habit of reading a particular newspaper. So, which newspaper does your father read?
Which game does he play on Sundays?
Yeah, which game does... He play on Sundays. When does he come? Like so and so, like you can say that when talking about, you have told that when you are working in an office and your friend, that means your colleague, he hasn't come and somebody has come. So, ayana gurinchi evaro vacharu. Maamulaga regular ga ayana enintiki vastaru ani adagali. So, adagalante, when does he come? Roju enintiki vastaru.
Then what is the answer for this question?
He comes. He comes usually 9 o'clock.
Yeah, he usually comes at 9. So, ipudu 8 ayindi. He usually comes at 9 o'clock. So, okay.
So, now you have come to know how to make use of WH words and making use of do and does. So, now you give some examples for yes or no questions. Making use of do and does.
Yeah.
Leave about WH word.
Okay.
Start with do.
Does she go to college regularly?
That's good. Okay, so does she go to college regularly?
Do they come here? Does Ramu understand the class?
So does Ramu understand classes? Okay, do you have doubt on Ramu or do you have doubt on the teacher?
Do they come here?
Do they come here? Okay, do they come here? Next.
Does she like banana?
Does she like bananas? Does she like bananas?
Do you know about this course?
Do you know about this course? Do you know about this course?
Does it correct?
Is it correct? ఎందుకంటే ఓకే వెర్ ఎవర్ వీ మేక్ యూజ్ ఆఫ్ డూ అండ్ డస్ ఫార్మ్స్ దెన్ ఆటో ఆ సబ్జెక్ట్ తర్వాత వీ వన్ ఈజ్ కంపల్సరీ మేకింగ్ యూజ్ ఆఫ్ వర్బ్ ఫస్ట్ ఫార్మ్ ఈజ్ కంపల్సరీ ఈజ్ ఇట్ కరెక్ట్ కరెక్ట్ ఈజ్ అన్ అడ్జెక్టివ్ కాబట్టి సో ఈజ్ ఇట్ కరెక్ట్ ఇట్స్ నాట్ డస్ ఇట్ కరెక్ట్ డూ యూ గో అవుట్ ఆన్ సండేస్ డూ ఆర్కేమట్ టీచర్స్ టీచ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఓకే డూ యూ రీడ్ బుక్స్
Yes.
Okay, so do you read newspaper? Do you go for jogging every day? Do you go for a walk every day? So talking about. Okay, so do you eat non-veg? Do you help your mother?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
In what way? Eating? Or in preparing also?
In preparing
food also, you help your mother. Okay. So, does your father help your mother?
Sometimes.
Rarely.
Okay. Rarely. Does your father give you pocket money?
Yes.
Regularly.
Okay, because he also knows that one. Do you take money from your father's pocket?
No. I use it to take.
Okay. So, without your father's permission, you don't take money from his pocket. So, instead of that, to avoid it, your father only gives you pocket money. Okay. So, then, okay. So, all these are the questions which we make use of for the regular activities and all. Okay. So, does your teacher give you chance to speak in the class?
Yes.
Yes.
She is
Yes, She gives chance. Okay. So in this way, okay, so do they concentrate on spoken English? Do the teachers concentrate on spoken English in VIOL?
Yes, they concentrate.
If you want to talk about your teacher, then teacher concentrates.
If you are talking about the teachers in Ramakrishna Math in general, teachers concentrate on spoken English in Ramakrishna Math. Do the teachers conduct seminars for the students?
Yes, teachers conduct seminars for the students.
So in this way, so whenever you make use of do and does, then automatically you are starting your answer either with yes or no. Okay, so do you take breakfast before coming to class?
Yes, I take breakfast.
Yes, I take breakfast before coming to class. If the answer is no?
No, I don't take breakfast before coming to class.
So in this way, so whenever the questions are started with yes, that means do or does, then automatically answers you have to start either with yes or no. Okay, so take down some sentences for the practice. So you need to practice this structures so that, okay, so whenever there is a need and you can make use of this, and you write plenty of examples like what do you do on Sundays or how do you celebrate a festival, how do you celebrate Diwali, Dashara, or whatever it may be, how do you celebrate a particular festival, the way you celebrate. So in that way, if you write, then you will be perfect in the sentences. Okay. Teachers help students the train reaches on time. It works well . My parents call me . She watches movies. For these 5 sentences, okay, you write negative form and question form. Question form is yes or no question.
Parents undi madam, parents ku parent adi parents calls vastha call.
Parents, because parents plural form, so we make use of V1 form here. So if you are talking about your mother, then if you say that one, my mother calls me. Parents plural kabatti, parents ni plural ante they tho substitute cheyochu. So anduke call an antunam. Ade okay, my mother gaani father gaani unte, then ikkada s form gaani s form gaani add cheyali. So for these sentences, okay, so teachers help students. So teachers kuda plural kabatti manam v1 form use chesamu. Ade ikkada train singular kabatti we have added v1 plus sres form anamata. ఈ 5 సెంటెన్సెస్ కి ద నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ యు రైట్ ద నెగటివ్ ఫార్మ్ అండ్ యు ఆల్సో రైట్ ఎస్ ఆర్ నో క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ దిస్ సో బిఫోర్ వెనెవర్ యు రైట్ దీస్ సెంటెన్సెస్ యు ఆల్వేస్ కీప్ ఇన్ మైండ్ సో ఇఫ్ యు హ్యావ్ v1 టు ఫార్మ్ ఈస్ డోంట్ ప్లస్ v1 అండ్ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఫార్మ్ ఈస్ డు ప్లస్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ప్లస్ v1 ఇఫ్ యు హ్యావ్ v1 ప్లస్ sres ఫార్మ్
Doesn't plus V1 is the negative and does plus subject plus V1 is the question form.
So in this way, you can also check, underline the verb. Okay, so don't worry too much about the subject here. You concentrate on the verb and you do these 5 sentences.
Hello everyone, good day to you all. Now let us improve our English by listening to an interesting conversation between 2 friends.
Hello Rajesh.
Hello Sai.
May I ask you a question?
Yes, carry on Sai.
Generally, who takes us to the school?
Obviously, it's her father.
Yes, Rajesh, absolutely, I agree with you. So, mother introduces you to the world.
Right.
And next powerful role starts is our father.
Yes.
So, father will train you how to be responsible in this world.
Right.
What is your opinion on this?
Yes. According to our Indian culture, sir, Matru Deva Bhava, Pitru Deva Bhava, Acharya Deva Bhava and Atithi Deva Bhava.
Right.
Father is considered like a god.
Right.
He is the emotional backbone of every family.
Every family.
Yes, I strongly believe in that. What you have said, that is absolutely right.
Right.
Yeah. Would you like to say anything about the importance of father?
Yes, Rajesh, absolutely. Like absolutely, Rajesh, in Ramayana,
okay,
we see the powerful character is Dasharatha Maharaju.
Yes.
And his son is obviously Rama.
Yes.
So, the most important thing which strikes to my mind in this role of father is Pitruvak Paripalana, obeying the father's words. And here, Dasharatha Maharaju, that is the father of Lord Sri Rama, has instructed his son to go for exile for 14 long years.
Exile means Aranyavasam.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
And ikkada, Lord Sri Rama has followed his father's words and that obedience is there.
Yes. Pitruvak Paripalana.
Pitruvak Paripalana.
Yes.
Means, don't forget, we should not forget our father and don't forget your father.
Yes.
Because without him, we are nothing.
We are nothing, yes.
So, what is your opinion on this?
Yes, he takes care of his children.
Yes.
Then just, and also I strongly believe that father is the first friend for every child.
Every child. Exactly, Rajesh.
Yes.
Means we don't feel any inhibitions.
Yeah. Father daggara edaina sare we can
edaina manam open ga cheptam.
Yes.
Adi amma daggara alla manam cheppam.
Yes.
So and ale ala manaku vidhamaina friend lagane ani cheppochu.
Yes.
So and generally parents especially father will never reveal any of his weakness.
Yes.
So whatever the condition of family may be, he always tries to
keep his
children happily.
Yes.
Right. And
he
also
carry all the responsibility of the family.
Exactly.
Yes.
And when we settle in our life, we should not forget.
Yeah, it's our duty, it's our responsibility.
It's our
bounden. We take care of our parents and we should not disrespect them.
Yes.
We have to respect them.
Yes.
They are living gods.
Living gods. So it's our bounden duty and responsibility.
They are worthy of worship.
Yeah, it's our bounden duty and responsibility to take care of them in every time of their need.
Yes, our Indian culture also just has given utmost importance for mother and father.
Mother and father.
Yes, it's like a upper lid and you know, just, can you just elaborate this one?
Yeah? Yes, Rajesh, why not? Kastam vachinappudu, amma nana manani kastam.
Yes, kastam padakunda. వాళ్ళు మనని కన్ను గుడ్డుకి కన్ను రెప్పలు ఎలాగో రక్షణ
ఎలా అయితే
మనకు తల్లిదండ్రులు అనేది మన జీవితంలో దే కెన్ ప్రొటెక్టర్స్
దట్స్ వాట్ ఐ యామ్ ట్రైయింగ్ టు టెల్ యు అండ్
వి ఆర్ వెల్ టేకెన్ కేర్ బై దెం
yes అండ్ ఆల్సో వాట్ ది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఇస్ వెన్ వి ఆర్ యంగ్ దే టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ నీడ్స్ వెరీ వెల్
yes
అండ్ వెన్ దే బికమ్ ఓల్డ్
we should
our responsibility
must, we
to
must
take care of them.
Yes.
So we should be very responsible in this aspect.
But
then only
so,
the circle of love and affection.
It's so painful to see these old age homes.
Right.
Yes. They're sending their parents to the old age home. It's really painful. You see, because when we are a child, they take care of us.
Right.
But when they're in old age, it's our duty to take care of them.
Right.
It's very important because they are like kids. They are like they are also like children at the time because they need someone's hand.
Right.
So we have to do our role.
Right.
Because that's called the highest form of worship.
Right.
Which I believe.
That's what I am telling Rajesh. Our circle of love and affection becomes complete only when you serve them.
Yes.
So hope Rajesh we had a very nice
discussion
yesterday about the role of father.
We just discussed the importance of
I
the greatness of
I have recollected all my
childhood
memories which I had with my father.
Yes, and also
hope you too had great time.
So you reminded about Ramayana also scripture.
absolutely.
I also got the just reminder of Ramayana.
Hello everyone. Now it is story time. Let us listen to this interesting story, understand the sentence construction and improve our English from it.
What am I doing? Well, I am biting my nails. Well, is it a good habit to bite nails? No. But in fact, many people have this habit. Well, it's a bad habit. We all know that. And you know, nails carry a lot of infections. There's some dirt and dust here, okay? And putting your fingers in your mouth always is not good. And especially, well, if you bite your nails very deep, so you get some kind of infection also. It's not at all good, okay? But many people have this habit, okay? And some people have the habit of chewing the pencil ends, okay? And some people have the habit of, you know, scratching their head. See, people have habits, of course, okay? But, ee alavatli, chedda alavatla anevi, ilantivi anta harmful kaadu, even though they are harmful. But alavatla anevi, ee extent enkaina vellachu. So, kontamandiki smoking alavatu untundi, drinking alavatu untundi. So, ilanti alavatlu manishini cheddu darloki teeskeltayi, okay? Ivi telugulo oka samethu undi. మొక్కై వంగనిది మానై వంగుతుంది అని. అంటే మొక్క చిన్నగా ఉన్నప్పుడు వాటిని వంచడం ఈజీ మొక్కని. సో అదే పెద్ద చెట్టు కింద అయితే వంచలేం. ఓకే, సో ఈ హ్యాబిట్స్ని జనరల్గా అలాగా కంపేర్ చేస్తాం. సో ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్ ఆల్సో యాక్చువల్లీ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ వండర్ఫుల్ కొటేషన్ అబౌట్ దిస్. ఓకే, అండ్ దాట్ ఈస్ ఓల్డ్ హ్యాబిట్స్ డై హార్ట్. ఎన్ ఎల్డర్లీ టీచర్ వాజ్ టేకింగ్ ఎ వాక్ విత్ హిస్ డిసైపుల్స్ త్రూ ఎ ఫారెస్ట్. డిసైపుల్స్ అంటే శిష్యులు. సడన్లీ హీ స్టాప్డ్ అండ్ పాయింటెడ్ టు ఫోర్ ప్లాంట్స్ క్లోజ్ ఎట్ హ్యాండ్. ద ఫస్ట్ వాజ్ జస్ట్ బిగినింగ్ టు పీప్ అబౌ ద గ్రౌండ్. పీప్ అంటే జస్ట్ చిన్న మొలక రావడం, తొంగి చూడడం యాక్చువల్గా పీప్ అంటే. అండ్ ద సెకండ్ హ్యాడ్ రూటెడ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ప్రెటీ వెల్ టు ద ఎర్త్. ద థర్డ్ వాజ్ స్మాల్ ష్రబ్ అండ్ వైల్ ద ఫోర్త్ వాజ్ ఎ ఫుల్ సైజ్డ్ ట్రీ. సో ఫస్ట్ ఇది చిన్న మొలక, రెండోది కొంచెం పెరిగిన చిన్న మొక్క, అండ్ మూడోది పొద, అండ్ నాలుగవది పెద్ద ట్రీ. అండ్ ద టీచర్ సెడ్ టు హిస్ యంగ్ డిసైపుల్స్, పుల్ అవుట్ ద ఫస్ట్ ప్లాంట్, అండ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ డిడ్ సో ఈగర్లీ యూజింగ్ హిస్ ఫింగర్స్. సో గురువు చెప్తే ఏ పనైనా చేయడానికి సిద్ధంగా ఉంటారు శిష్యులు. సో అది ఆ చిన్న మొక్కని తీసేయమని చెప్పారు గురువు గారు. సో ఈగర్లీ అంటే చాలా ఉత్సాహంగా ఒక స్టూడెంట్ వెళ్ళి అది లాగేశాడు, పీకేశాడు. అండ్ నౌ పుల్ అవుట్ ద సెకండ్, హీ సెట్. అనదర్ డిసైపుల్ ఒబేడ్ బట్ ఫౌండ్ ద జాబ్ మోర్ డిఫికల్ట్. సో ఇంకొక అతను వెళ్ళి కొంచెం పెరిగిన మొక్కని పీకాడు, బట్ విత్ ఎ లిటిల్ మోర్ డిఫికల్టీ. ఓకే, అండ్ డూ ద సేమ్ విత్ ద థర్డ్, హీ అర్జ్డ్. ద థర్డ్ డిసైపుల్ హ్యాడ్ టు యూజ్ ఆల్ హీ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ టు అప్రూట్ ఇట్. ఇట్ వాజ్ డిఫికల్ట్ అండ్ టుక్ మోర్ టైమ్. అప్రూట్ అంటే మొత్తం వేళ్లతో సహా పెకిలించడం. అండ్ నౌ ట్రై యువర్ హ్యాండ్ టు అప్రూట్ ద ఫోర్త్, సెట్ ద టీచర్. ఆల్ ద డిసైపుల్స్ లుక్డ్ ఎట్ ద స్టర్డీ ట్రంక్ విత్ ఆల్ ఇట్స్ బ్రాంచెస్ స్ప్రెడ్ అబౌట్. స్టర్డీ అంటే వెరీ స్ట్రాంగ్, చాలా బలమైన చెట్టు. అండ్ దే కుడ్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ షేక్ ఇట్స్ బ్రాంచెస్, లీవ్ ఎలోన్ ద ట్రంక్. అండ్ సో మై డియర్ సన్స్, this is what happens with our bad habits. When they are young, they can be removed easily, but when they are old, they are hard to get rid of, said the teacher. Get rid of ante teesedo, okay, ante tolaginchukovadam. So habits anevi chaala balanga paatukipothayi pedda chettilaaga. So enta early ga vaatini manam teesiste anta manchidi, okay. And the good habits can be grown and bad habits should be nipped at the bud.
Hello everyone, good day to you all. And now we will see a quote. We will see, we will read, and we shall understand what the quote is. Thank you. everyone. Now let us listen to an anecdote. Anecdote is nothing but a small story, an incident that occurred in a great personality's life. Let us listen to this and improve our English. Hello all.
Good day to you all. Today we're going to listen to a small anecdote, which was an incident that occurred in Swami Vivekananda's life. Now this is a very small anecdote, but it has a big message. So Swami Vivekananda had tons of admirers because he used to speak so beautifully in so many countries. There were a lot of people who began to take him as their role model. One such person was Josephine McLeod. Now this woman was one of the greatest admirers of Swami Vivekananda, and she began to see him as her friend, a person to whom she can look up to in times of difficulty. One day, Miss McLeod asked Swami Vivekananda, "Swamiji, how can I best help you?" Swami Vivekananda very simply answered with only two words, "Love India," he told to Josephine. Now that is all, very small anecdote, but just think, for a person like Swami Vivekananda, who is from India, an Indian, to tell a foreigner to love my country, how much patriotism and how much boldness he must have. It is very easy for an Indian to tell a fellow Indian, love your country, love India. There's not a very big deal in that. But for an Indian to tell a British person or an English person, love India, is a real sense, it is a sign of great patriotism. And I think it is that sense of patriotism that all of us should have in ourselves on every single day, not only on special days like Independence Day or Republic Day.
Exactly.
It's a bad habit nowadays that we are not practicing our patriotism, our love of country on every day. We should be proud to be Indians, don't you think?
Absolutely. We need to be proud. We need to own up to the fact that we are proud children of this beautiful motherland. It so happens that we observe nowadays everybody wants to pursue their masters. So many of them go either to America, to Germany or any other foreign country. It so happens that once you are gone to that country, you completely forget about India and Indian culture. You are okay with following the rules, the culture of those countries, and you appreciate all the foreign countries, but you don't do that and you don't follow, you don't be disciplined in your own country. That is the most common practice that we are seeing that is happening. Absolutely, that is a malpractice. I think we should also be aware that we are born and brought up here. Our roots, our basic education is from our family, from our school, which is all in this country. So let us learn to respect whether we are here, whether we are anywhere else. Let us always keep that in mind. Let us not only appreciate and work and completely be slaves to somebody else's rules and discipline. Let us also be proud of our rules, our culture and our discipline over here.
Exactly. There's one point I'd like to add here. Now, as you said, some of us may, for some reason, go to another country, foreign country. And over there, we will have to respect the culture and the guidelines set by that society, which is not wrong, because if someone comes to India, they will also respect our culture.
Exactly.
But what I feel is that it is good for you to respect other people's culture, but it is even better for you to stick to your culture and show your culture wherever you go.
True.
So like
True.
If you are, suppose some of us go to America. Over there, they have their own culture, their own lifestyle, their
Completely
own traditions.
Westernized.
It's very different, westernized. It's different traditions also. Mm. And we must never insult those traditions or culture. We must respect them. But at the same time, we should still be as proud to be Indian as we are when we are in India.
Exactly.
That
we are taking a little India within us wherever we are going.
Exactly.
So let us keep that within us safe, proud, and let us also make others also feel proud of our culture,
exactly.
of ourselves.
Very true.
And I am sure this was an excellent anecdote. It was a short one with a message that caused a great impact to all of us.
Yeah, so let's all continue that sense of patriotism and keep that bit of Mother India in us wherever we go. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.